Okay, so today I want to tear down this JBL Clip2. This device is waterproof under IPX7, and I want you to be aware, if you decide to do this at home too, then you're most likely going to destroy this ability, so it will no longer be waterproof up to 3 feet. Just want you to be aware. So I'm going to start with removing the front here. You can see and hear that this is relatively easy. You just jam your fingernails behind here, and then here you can already see this is pretty much just glued on. There's this black tar kind of stuff that covers the four screws here, and then there's two more screws here in the middle. Okay, so let's start out with opening these two big screws here, and then let's see if we can remove that tweeter here. There you go. You can already have a peek inside here. Here on the bottom you can see the battery. Now let's see how we can open this part up. So here in this close-up you can see how there's on the screw they have this clear paint or something on it, on the screw and inside of the thread probably, just to keep the water out. And so you can't really get in through the slots here with your screwdriver. So you first have to, I'm using a safety pin here to get some of that paint out so that I can open this. Okay, so I'm removing the last of those four screws here. Alright, let's see what we got here. First, second seal here. Carefully taking that off. And then we have here the connector for the tweeter. See how that works. Now we have the tweeter here. And the seal. Don't want to forget that later. Couple of screws here, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Let's remove those really quick. So now the board here should be free, but you can see here there's all kinds of this putty here. This is a super thick goop that holds all the connections to the outside in place and make sure they're watertight. For example, here the in feed for the aux jack, and then we have here the USB. We're trying to keep those watertight. This is here the microphone, same thing here.
So here I just loosened the wire for the aux jack so that there's enough room for me. But then on this side we have the USB. The USB port is right on the PCB. Let's see how easy it is to get this putty off. Just going to carefully go between here. Trying to loosen it from the plastic case. That seems to work pretty good, actually, better than I thought. Let's see if that is enough. I'm checking all the other areas here. We have the microphone. Just trying to loosen the wire here to give it enough slack. Now I'm going to also get rid of this ribbon here.
Okay. Now, in theory, this should be everything that I need to loosen. The only part that's really still on is probably the USB port here.
So here we have the wire for the battery that goes between the USB port and then here this switch, the on-off switch. So now, to replace the battery, then you want to saw these points off, cut the wire, then you can lift the PCB board out. Here is the information for the battery.
730 milliamps, 3.7 volts. This one is also nicely gooped in place.